Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this animation we're going to add little noises behind our animations to make them feel more real, like this guy, creatives. Now there is an ongoing debate in our household about... There he is. Okay, you see that little blop noise? Let's go figure out where we can find them and how to implement them. Okay, so let's first of all find our sound. Okay, so if you need sounds for like interface kinds of things, like we're gonna do for this pop, you need some clicks, you need some bumps, some groans, just like little noises. Often the term to look for is interface noises, and there's no real one place. I use freesounds.org quite a bit because the licensing allows me to use them free, but double check the licenses before you go and use them. And the weird thing is looking for them. Like say you want a noise and you can hear it in your head, okay? I'm not sure if I'm explaining that right, but you know what the noise is, but how do you describe it in words? So you might go zap. Okay, you're like in, is this the noise? Ooh. Wow. Okay, so, or bloop is the one I want. Okay, that's the one I wanted. Okay, none of those were weird. You can download them easy by clicking on them and downloading. I've got one ready for us in this animation. So let's jump into After Effects. What I did was in your audio files that we brought in earlier, I've made this blop, okay? And actually just recorded it myself. I made a noise that like, I made a noise on my microphone like this, okay? Or, okay, any of those little noises I use quite a bit for my animations because A, I get the exact noise that I want and I get to use them commercially because I made them. You're allowed to use my blop whenever you like, okay? You have my full rights. So what I'd like to do is just time it right. Okay, so when the house appears, I'm gonna bring in this blop. Nice. And what I might have to do as well is turn my audio back on just to get the timing right. So I'm gonna turn on the value of sleep, turn the sound on. Now, try and time it all together. In our household about the value. Probably needs to come along a little bit. That's not bad. Okay, everyone's is gonna be slightly different because you're working on your own file. Maybe a little bit further along. And then it comes down to a little bit of art that's trying to get everything timed nicely. That feels okay. It's maybe going a bit slow, my little pop as well. So anyway, we've looked at where to get sounds from. Okay, we've made our own and we've applied it. These are one of the things that get often overlooked when you're like watching somebody else's infographic and you're like, oh, that's cool. And you don't notice all the little noises in the background that kind of add the life to the little animations. Okay, so just keep an ear out for those sorts of noises and see if you can find similar ones. And don't forget to add it to your own work. All right, let's get on to the next video. Hey there, what'd you think? If you like the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.